And Kelly, no arrest today in the case of that principal accused of molesting students. But the school is still shut down, and that's left parents wondering what's going to happen next there. KCRA3's David Bienick is live for us in Citrus Heights with the developments that happened today. David?
Edie, good evening. Yes, this is a private school, and parents tell us they paid $600 a month in tuition. They say they like this kind of semi-rural setting here in Citrus Heights with a horse pasture out front and seemingly so far away from this kind of trouble. Parents returned to Creative Frontier School today looking for answers about why the school is now closed and its principal under investigation for possible child molestation.
I mean, I've known him for so long, I just can't believe it. I'm shocked.
The school's website lists Bob Adams not only as the principal, but also as the founder and owner of this private elementary and preschool since 1975.
We are kind of pissed off because they say they know on Thursday they're going to shut the school. And we find out yesterday.
Citrus Heights police say they've completed searches and collected evidence from the school site and also from Adams' home, which records indicate it's this house in an upscale neighborhood of Folsom.
Well, you can understand it's a sensitive investigation. That's why we're moving slow. We're taking this cautiously. We're taking it step by step.
Court records indicate that Creative Frontiers has been sued a dozen times, including by the County of Sacramento in 2000 for a complaint related to employment. Parents and former students who we've talked with so far have nothing but praise for the school and the man at its head.
It's kind of disappointing because it kind of destroys everything I thought I knew about him.
I think he's a warm, comforting man, and so therefore those, you know, that type of person can be taken differently.
And even though a sign out front says enrollment is going on right now, the parents of nearly 200 students are scrambling tonight to try to find them some other school to be in classes in just a few weeks. Meanwhile, the lawyer for Bob Adams says she sees some irregularities in the way the police have handled this case and plans to have more to say about that tomorrow. Live in Citrus Heights, David Bienick, KCRA3 Report.